Greetings and hallucinations, ladies and lads. I am Chancellor of the Harmonious Frequencies of the Mighty Empire of Onion, and this is RimWorld. So we've had a pretty quiet time the past couple of episodes. Nothing much has happened. We had a couple of cargo pods drop some chocolate. Last time, that was pretty nice. That'll be good for the joy around the place. We're still trying to recruit Sparkles, the space refugee. We're also trying to recruit the other two prisoners, but they seem like they're going to be quite a bit more difficult. Get over to our side. So I am expecting something to happen soon, probably a raid. Possibly even mechanoids. Hopefully not, though. We'll have to see how it goes. We're doing pretty well on food still. A little bit low on meals. We had some deteriorate because of the heat. I think I thought that Tapir was over his middle break, but I think he's still in it. He doesn't have the catharsis bonus yet, and I think his name is still kind of blue. It's a really light blue, so it's hard for me to tell. Oh, he's got the lightning bolt, though, so he's for sure wandering in psychosis. Yeah, she had an infection, but I don't think anybody does right now. I think everybody's pretty good. Yeah, Sparkles went berserk last episode, so that's why everybody's beat up in here. This place is still pretty messy. They, of course, bring the dead animal bodies in there, so gonna be blood everywhere. Okay, Tapir's no longer wandering. But he is pretty low on joy and beauty. His mood is way up though now, so he should come back to us pretty easy. Oh, he's gone berserk though, right after I say that. I wonder if that's mostly from all the blood. I imagine that it is. Let's see if we can get Camino to do a bunch of cleaning. Oh, Gracie will clean. Maybe I get her to help as well. I think that's probably the plan for right now. Cutting a tree. Maybe she's doing it for the wall? Construction? I don't know. Here's pretty well out of the way though, so even though he's gone berserk, I'm sure he'll be fine. It doesn't seem like he's gonna make any problems for anybody. Not sure why this is staying open. Nothing in front of it, so it honestly shouldn't be. Oh, don't pick on the turkey. Come on. He will bite your face. Oksana, don't go in there. Go somewhere else. Yeah, I'm really not sure why that's staying open. Gracie's doing some cleaning way outside, which is fine, I suppose. He still does never do hauling. I don't know if y'all have realized this. I think we go ahead and try to clean up Tapir's room so that if he goes to rest later on, he'll have a nice place to rest at. Assuming he doesn't That'll scare her off. Process. She'll probably end up trying to flee once she gets close to him. No, she's not. Oh ho! Tough girl. That's good. Or maybe she fled into there and then decided to clean. I don't know. I wasn't paying attention to what she was doing. Minio's getting this area cleaned up. That's good. Go beat up Elk. Come on. Didn't have anything to do with it. Animal starvation. Oh. Rexo is feeding them raw foods, which is not the best. A dull barracks, though, is not the worst. If we had both of these plants planted, I have a feeling that that wouldn't be a problem anymore. Acute pain, that's fine. Naked, that's a bit of a problem. Hates being locked up. Oh, she's prosophile, so she wants a bionic part. That's not going to change for a long time. Say we put a stockpile zone in here. Oh, beating up on the pig now. What a monster. And can allow pants, but I think tribal wear is going to be the one. So whenever somebody finally gets around to making some over here, then we can do that. I'm pretty sure that we have the ingredients. Yeah, it's only 35 per. We can make it out of deer hide, and that's about it. Oh. Poisoned the poor turkey. Okay, nobody uses this room either. Nobody uses this room. So it looks like most of the rooms are pretty well cleaned up. Brixo's doing some doctoring for the animals. Man, I'm really surprised he's last this long. I thought that by now he would have gotten back to normal a bit. I do wish that there was a way to negotiate with them once they had gone berserk. Like, say you have a character or two with a high social skill, then maybe they could convince them to calm down or something like that. What? Dead turkey? There's our turkey, so this must have just been a wild turkey. I feel like the fox probably killed it or something, but there it was. If we can get her to land over here. Oh, beating up. Man, Tapir, you really need to chill out, buddy. Let's just risk him first, though. Can't do it. There we go. Alright, Wild Boar 2 is capable of walking again, that's good. Gracie's cleaning up the infirmary a bit. I didn't know that the animals were prone to vomiting. That's interesting. Suppose it makes sense because animals totally have the capability of vomiting. Where's he off to? There he is. I mean, his mood isn't even all that bad, but he's just remaining berserk. I suppose that's going to exist until he passes out. He needs to go play some horseshoes. Moderate amount of pain, ugly environment. Oh, he is still beat up. And worse now that he was messing with the animals there. Takes him a lot longer to heal whenever he's not taking care of himself, sleeping in a medical bed. Oh. See, Tapir, see what you've done. Wild boar who was miraculously pregnant with no male boars around. Now she's miscarried because you're being a total jerk. Now he's fighting the turkey. Alright. Oh. Alright. Take your time, Brixo. Not too worried about it right now. He is running back and forth though, which is not good, so. Tapir, you really need to calm down, man. No, you're in a great mood. Come on. Gonna be totally fine. Suppose her and Tapir I would set to self 10. It'll be a lower quality, but it's totally fine with me. Yeah, prioritize tending to break set. That's pretty cool. I like that. Bleeding? She is bleeding. I probably ought to let her do that. There she goes. Wow. Not too shabby, I'd say. Not sure what's going on here because it seems like his mood is only 24%, but I always thought that this arrow was an indicator of where it was going. where it was trending towards. Yeah, and his catharsis times two is really helping him out with that. Hey, you better tend to Turkey 3. You were the one who was beating her up. Destroyed her foot. Big jerk. Probably be a good idea to get rid of these boom rats basically as soon as possible. Who's starving? Tapir? Tapir, why are you starving, brother? Eating a simple meal to the turkey, but you're hungry yourself. Well thought. Once again, I'm pretty sure he's just gonna take 10 potatoes. You're running back and forth all day like a fool. Instead of cooking like he's supposed to be. Bracey's making sure everything's clean. Maybe I'll get her to crafting. See if we can make some tribal wear for Sparkles here. Unless somebody else grabs it, because I'm pretty sure. Yeah, we have a lot of tattered apparel around. Dorkagope of the mountain. Hostile. They've spawned right on top of us, too. Prepare for a while before they attack. They're all melee guys. Minnow, you're in kind of a bad place, girl. Looks like they're moving over to that area, so maybe we just let the animals go wherever they want to. Stupid is running right through the middle. I can't blame him because I kind of told him to go there, but great. Well, Tapir is eating. So Brixo may need to eat something? No, she's trying to feed a meal to somebody else. Gracie, you're good. You and Brixo can get drafted up. And we'll come around here. As far as I remember, neither one of them have movement problems. Minio, Gracie, yeah. So we should be at our max speed with them or whatever. We shouldn't have to worry about going super slow. He's going after Stupid right there. I haven't drafted her, so I... It's interesting behavior. I'm not sure why they turned around right then. Ouch. Got the really bad bruises there. Alright. Except that has inspired them to attack. Imagine we only have to kill about one or maybe two in order to get them to flee. Oh no! No, no, that's not at all what I... Wow. Was expecting to happen. Come on now. Nope. Tapir's down. Okay, play. Oh no, Brixo is down as well. Right middle toe destroyed. And whenever I saw that Breakso, no, that Kamenyo had a bad torso injury that was red, I was sure that I needed to tell her to get out of there. Crack to the jaw, bruise on his left arm and his left leg. Elias, I know your medicine is pretty crummy. Crazy camp medicine. Get to here taken care of, and then Breakso can get taken care of after that, probably by Tapir. That looks like the last of our harvested potatoes. Yeah, she must be cutting down this tree because of the construction. She would do that though until we had the blocks to build there with. Severe pain. That's not what we needed. Yep, his friend Camino died. Witnessed Ally's death. Their corpses, disturbed sleep, all of that. Terrible. So bad. We're pretty low on food, so we do need to get some hunting done. Is not what I wanted to see happen. All right, Sparkles, we need your help badly. Like you have no idea. You almost got her right leg taken off there. That would have been really bad. I'm surprised that she got to the condition where she could walk so quickly. Turkey hasn't started rotting, I don't think. Nope, still fresh. Boils in less than a day, though. Maybe we can get it butchered out and get a little bit of meat over here. Ant, here. Come on, bro. Oh, one more torso bruise to patch. Alright, so we've got that done. Good. Wearing deerhide tribal wear. I'm pretty sure he does have tattered apparel. I could get him to make the next pair though, because I noticed that he's set to be a crafter. He has a really high passion for it, so maybe he'll be able to learn some things. But that's where I'm going to have to leave it for this episode. If you want to catch the next one, feel free to subscribe. Consider supporting if you would. And be sure to check out any of my other videos or playlists that you might be interested in. I thank you very much for any time you spend on my channel, and I hope blessings of wisdom and peace on all of you. Farewell.